I'm Peter Shin with Ann Coulter, and we're here at the Marriott in Washington, D.C., and, you know, I think one of the biggest things about you is that you like to just not go after the popularity contest.
Okay?
And that's putting it mildly,
yes.
Right? And when we talk about the life issues, abortion is not one of those topics that people like to talk about.
Right.
But you definitely throw it out there. You like to, you know, bring that up as, you know, there's the party of abortion.
Yes.
You know,
yes, that is the Democrats. I like to do it because I like to taunt liberals. I think there are a lot of people who are with conservatives on abortion, probably more like these people than they are like me, who just don't want to talk about it. They will vote against it, but they don't want to talk about it. But sometimes you kind of have to make people talk about it. What I'm frustrated with now is that, oddly enough, we have this model marrying libertine on Fifth Avenue who's the one who's going to save the country for us, the last Christian country on earth. Oh well, sometimes your saviors come in odd packages. But mm-hmm. But to have people, and I hope you don't mind that I'm diverging into something topical and political,
yeah.
But to have, you know, my side on the life issue and Christian issue, I think they're probably past this now. But to be denouncing Trump when, if he loses, Hillary wins, and we're looking at 9 Ruth Bader Ginsburgs on the Supreme Court.
Yeah.
And also, what have we gotten from these guys, at least the politicians? I'm a little frustrated with my party, or my ex-Republican party. They talk a good game on abortion, but what have we gotten out of it?
Exactly. That's right.
No, send me the model marrying libertine.
Well, and you know what? Every 4 years, they come up, they put their arms
yes.
around us, and they're like,
yes.
let's talk. And then it's done, and they get elected, and then they walk away, and it's like, see you next time.
Yes.
And you
no,
know,
they treat us the way the Democrats treat the blacks.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. That's
see you
right.
in 4 years.
See you in 4 years. And so that's what we've been going through. And I've made myself unpopular because whenever I get in front of a podium, I ask the Republicans, and especially if we're at events, what are you doing?
Right.
You know, I mean, it's like you say, get me elected and I'm going to take care of this issue.
Right.
Well, when was the last time they submitted a bill to end abortion? I mean,
well,
after
they've
all,
done.
I mean, let's look at. Let's
it was
look.
Back in the Bush era, I think, when they were finally doing some good stuff. I mean,
well, there was the Born Alive Infants Protection Act. That was one of the things.
Yeah.
But, you know, and of course that's critical. But
it's brilliant, and to be cutting along the edges like that. I mean, I got to tell you, I don't want to keep in submitting bills that will overrule abortion because they're faking
mm-hmm.
you out.
Mm-hmm.
They'll say, "Oh, look what I submitted. It's never going to pass.
Right.
The Supreme Court will strike it down." But this coming at it from the edges until we can get a Supreme Court that will
mm-hmm.
say,
"That's right."
Send it back to the states.
That's
and
exactly
I've had it with our people being moral show-offs,
mm-hmm.
Like, I'm sorry, Todd Akin and Richard Murdoch. What is the point of this? We want to send it back to the states. And I kind of liked that Trump said when pressed, yeah, I guess women should be punished for having abortions.
Well,
and the
I
whole
mean, if
pro-life
a kills
movement
somebody,
jumped
and that's
on
what we're
him.
That's talking about, right?
But it was totally unfair. I mean, I'm punished for double parking.
Yeah.
He didn't say what the punishment was.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean capital punishment. It could
right.
be a fine.
Or it could be go to counseling and
it could
and
be go to counseling
and help
but
other
of
women.
Of course
yeah.
there has to be some sort of punishment.
Mm-hmm.
But
yeah.
in any event
yeah.
it was an unfair question
yeah.
and this is where sometimes we do get into we say we want a non-politician.
Mm-hmm.
You got one this year.
Yeah.
And sometimes he has to learn to say, I'm not running for state legislature. That's not going to be my issue.
Mm-hmm.
Very important. Let's talk about the issues the president deals with.
Yeah, right. Well, and picking the people that he's been picking, I think, is outstanding. I mean,
picking
Marjorie Dannenfeldter and, you know, and really saying to the pro-life community, as an example, I'm looking at you. I'm talking to you. I know he is. I have talked
yes.
to people, and he's actually met with us. He's trying to say, what do you want me to do?
Yes.
And picking Marjorie, I think, was one of the best things that he could have done.
Well,
and,
also, I really liked...
And the Supreme Court, of course.
Yeah, well, that's the big one.
Yeah, that's
the big kahuna.
Mm.
That's why I even voted for McCain, so these... These swine can vote for one who isn't quite their cup of tea.
Well, it's funny. I mean, you know, year after year, they tell us, well, we know you don't really like the guy, but vote for him anyway, because we all need to be together.
And now there's one they don't like.
And then they tell us,
sorry, well, taking the ball and going home.
Yeah.
No, and I write about this in Trump We Trust. I actually really liked his answer at the first debate on abortion because it was so genuine and believable that, yes, he used to be pro-choice. Of course he was. He lived in New York on Fifth Avenue. That's just in the air. I mean, he used to basically have the opinions of just what's in the air on most things. But he said he knew a woman who was going to have an abortion, and she didn't, and he knew the child now, and she had grown into this incredible star. He used some good Trumpian language, just a fantastic star. And that just seems totally believable to me. I think a lot of people came to be against abortion that way. They don't want to think about it, so if everyone's yelling at them to be pro-choice, they'll say, okay, if it means that much to you. But then they have some sort of experience in their own lives, often their own kids, sometimes somebody else's kid, who was not aborted. And that is how they change their minds. And I just prefer a real person's answer and not the poll-tested politician's answer.
Yeah, and he's real.
Yes.
That's the thing. When you talk to Donald, I could tell anybody who's talking to him, I think that's one of the things that they're hoping for. Whenever you see the mainstream media, they're just hoping that he's going to fall somehow because he's just so off the cuff and straight at you.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been impressed with everything he said. I mean, I know some of the things may be rough on the edges, but so what? I don't care. I mean, it's great. I love to see the brain aneurysms that you know people are going through with him. I mean, it's great. And you know, one of the things that we do, Life Issues for Leadership is one of the most important things that we think that we're trying to introduce through our Cherish Life Ministries project and helping leadership understand that they need to be involved, that they need to speak out and not be afraid of this. And,
right.
And you know, the 501c3, of course, you've talked about that in the past. I mean, it's one of the things that keeps the politicians, the pastors back from speaking about politics. And, you know, when you watch the movie, what was that one with Mel Gibson where the pastor, he gave the speech on whatever, then he took off his frock and then he goes off to fight the Revolutionary War.
Oh.
And, you know, in a similar way, I'm saying to the pastors out there and the church, the Christian leaders, you can't differentiate between the two. You can't just say, well, I'm going to talk here
well,
and not there.
Thing,
they kind of go together.
I'm sorry I'm seeming like a one-note Charlie, but I am. At Trump's convention speech, I never realized that the law that prohibits churches from taking a position in politics was an LBJ maneuver.
Yeah.
And he promises to repeal it, or try to repeal it. I mean, he is just the executive branch, but what a fantastic point. I'm so glad he mentioned it.
Yeah.
I've never heard a Republican talk about that before. I mean, maybe there's some, but I've never heard. I've certainly never heard it at a convention.
Yeah. Well, what do you say to Christians out there, Christian leaders, pastors, anybody who might be a little bit scared about the abortion topic? I mean, you're not scared. I mean, you hit it with both barrels on this subject whenever it comes up. And I think that's another thing that makes, you know, throws people off because they don't really want to talk about it.
Right.
So, you put them right on their heels and they're stepping back and I love it. Whenever I see that, I'm just like, yes.
Well, again, I enjoy annoying liberals. I guess there are different ways to go at it if you aren't like me and aren't doing it specifically to annoy liberals. But one point I think it's always worth mentioning in the first sentence is that the demographic that is most in favor of abortion are males between the ages of 18 and 30. Let's just mull on that for a moment. Why might that be? I mean, it's totally analogous to, well, so many debates, but the immigration debate. The rich want cheap labor and they walk around like they're Martin Luther King. Young men want to have responsibility-free sex, and so they're, I'm all for a woman's right to choose. No, come on, this is all, it's self-interested cads.
Yeah, and this is an important topic. I mean, there are, and I'm a one-trick pony. I mean, and people say, you know, well, you can't do that. You can't just be, you know, a one-issue guy. It's like, why not? I mean, to me, this is the most important issue there
is. Sobin's book, Single Issues. No, they always try to, well, I keep saying that about immigration now, because immigration is going to decide abortion.
Yeah.
If we have 9 Ruth Bader Ginsburgs on the
Supreme
Court.
That's right.
But yeah, this is how they try to diminish issues by saying that's a single issue. Well, you're the left single issue is destroying the United States of America, the last Christian country on earth. That's their single issue.
Yeah.
And they don't sleep.
Well, we're talking about 60 million people that have been killed by abortion in America, and that's a huge number of voters. So whenever they talk about, oh, we need all this illegal immigration, well, if we had 60 right. million more people in our country, we would have had all these workers that they talk about that
no,
they need.
That's right. And Jerry Falwell, perhaps he said it at the wrong time, but I didn't mind. I thought it was a good point when he said, look, we've turned away from God. God isn't going to protect us anymore. There are a lot of Christians out there, and I hope they're praying for the country, too, because, I mean, you do. When does God say, okay, America, I gave you your chance. you could not. You're murdering babies. All you can talk about is transgender bathrooms, child molestation in the Catholic Church, in the schools. It's through the roof. You have to wonder about the character of a country and how long we will have God's protection.
Yeah, definitely.
And it does start with, it starts with life and it goes on from there. I mean, I think a lot of the lack of respect for human beings once they're fully grown comes out of the ability to kill them when they're fetuses. Yeah, that's kind of a basic issue.
Yeah, it sure is. We hope you folks have been, you know, paying attention to this. You understand this is an important topic. It's an important issue, and it's okay to carry it. It's not something that you have to be afraid of. And you might be the person when you're walking down the aisle of the church and people say, oh, there comes that person, and that person's going to talk about abortion. But so what?
You know? Right, and you can do it. You can gauge your audience. You don't have to be a thorn in everyone's side. You can do it in a gentle way. But, yeah, it's an important issue.
Yeah. Well, thank you for taking the time to speak with us.
Thank you.
We appreciate that, and we hope you folks out there, you know, take something of this and take it out there, talk to other people, get involved, because we're the ones that are going to change things. It's our interaction that's going to make a difference. We can't just be silent about things. That's not going to do anything. If you see something, you have to get involved, and abortion is one of those important issues. Yes, it's definitely one of the key issues, I believe, in politics, and I'm so glad to see Donald Trump has stepped forward on this and said, I'm pro-life, I'm picking people who are pro-life, and I want you people in the pro-life community to know that I'm with you, and I'm so glad to see that. So thank you for taking the time to speak
to us. Thank you.